was Marilyn Manson's This Is the New Shit, and it's an awesome song. That being said, today, the freak is going to the Montreal 2022 Comic Con. That's right. So, I'm on my way there right now. It's a beautiful day, as you can see by the sun on my face. And the freak has a lot of money in his pocket. And we're going to go there early, get there, and check it out. I'm going to take a lot of pictures. A lot of people are going to be doing cosplay and all that. I'm going to buy a shitload of comics and see what's what, see what kind of celebrities are there and all that. And after I'm done, I'm going to do another little video showing you all the awesome comics that the freak's going to have bought during the day. So hey guys, stay tuned and I will be back. As you just saw, the Montreal Comic Con was awesome, and those are just a few of the pics that I did take. It was great. I just came out of there, and I bought a lot of books, and there was a lot of Star Wars and Star Trek cosplay, Japanimation too. I actually met a guy that was great. A guy that was dressed as the Punisher, like you saw in the pics. And he was super cool. Talked to him a little bit about how he did his costume and all that. Very, very cool guy. Cosplay of my favorite character of all time. And also, I saw and met the ex-MMA champion, GSP, and also, surprise, surprise, the two first round picks of the Montreal Canadiens were there, Juraj Slafkovský and Philip Mazar. They were super cool, but to me, the coolest thing at the Comic-Con was Mad Max's car. Now, it's not the original one. It's not the real one. It's a crazy, crazy ass fan who actually built it himself. I talked to him a little bit. And yeah, basically, it's all custom made. And the guy put a lot of money and a lot of time in that. And I totally, totally respect him. One day, hopefully, I got the time and the money to do that. I'd love to have the Dodge Interceptor, just like in Mad Max Road Warrior. That would be my personal dream car. Anyway, that was great. So, hey, after all of that time, you know, walking and hunting for comics and meeting people and all that, I am super thirsty. So, yeah, I need my Pepsi boy. Woo! And that hits the spot, because today it's like 30 degrees Celsius or so. So it's very, very hot. So guys, without further ado, I'm going to show you all the comic books that I bought at the convention. I spent around $300 in all. So without further ado, here are the comics that I bought. So you guys might know this, you might not know this, but some of my favorite all-time characters are Punisher, obviously, number one. And then I would say, I would go with Conan, Wolverine, Spawn, and Mad Max. Just to name a few. I got many others, like, you know, I love Green Lantern too, and Joker, and, you know, Batman, some Batman, pretty, really, really cool. Spider-Man's okay too. Anyway, so I was on the hunt for mostly Punisher and Conan comics, and guys, I had a great day, and no, I did not buy any mega keys, but I bought a shitload of books that I was missing in my personal collection, and, you know, sometimes you find great books at a good cost, and, you know, you pull the trigger. Anyway, so start with some of the very, very easy breezy books here. We got some Marvel True Believers. I know, they're not worth a lot, but Conan the Barbarian, reprint of the first appearance of Belit. That's a pretty cool book. All I want is to read it. It's, you know, classic comic book, classic artwork. The original one is worth too much money, especially when you just want to read a good story. That's what's important about comic books, guys. So I bought that. I also bought another True Believer, Conan the Barbarian. I think this is number 24, if I'm not mistaken. So the reprint of number 24. The original one of this is worth around $200 because it's the first appearance of Red Sonja. Great character also by Robert E. Howard. But, you know, $200 is not worth it because, again, all I want is to read a good story. So this is a great alternative. And I didn't even know this existed. Conan the Barbarian, and this is actually a reprint of Savage Tales number 5, I believe, which is a black and white magazine from the 70s, and that magazine is worth around $75-$80. You know, got it for a dollar. That's all good. some classic stuff that I had back when I was a teenager. Somehow, you know, got rid of it because at one point you're stupid. And I bought them again at like $3-4 each. Advanced Dungeons and Dragons number 1, number 2, and number 3. That's right. Good stuff, classic stuff. All right, let's move on. Surprise, surprise, I didn't expect to find this. But again, classic book, all fun. ElfQuest number 1. Another book that I used to have, but somehow, you know, I lost. Found it for like $5. Batman number 500, die cut cover. Very, very good artwork. Star Wars, the Boba Fett black armor variant, because why the hell not? Boba Fett is awesome. Star Wars, when the fat lady swings, Boba Fett. This was one of those rare Boba Fett comic books that I was missing for whatever reason. I'd never gotten my hands on it. Now I did. That's great. All right, so Punisher time. Believe it or not, guys, I found a full set of Punisher POV, and the number one that I did find has this printing defect, as you can see. So I don't know what the hell happened when they, you know, printed this, but it's kind of a cool item to have. Very, very rare, I guess, because it's a printing error. So with number 2, number 3, and number 4, some of those rare Punisher books that I was missing, classic Punisher books. Punisher number 1, is this the Alex Ross variant cover? Alex Ross Timeless cover. I'm gonna actually read it. I'm curious about the new Punisher. I don't like the new logo. We shall see. Anyway, beautiful cover. I'm willing to spend money just for the cover. Alex Ross is obviously one of the best of all time, so why the hell not, you know? Now, Moon Knight number 5, the David Finch series. I am looking for number 1 to 4 and number 6. I know it's quite rare in demand, highly sought after. This is the only one that I found out of the 6, and I paid like $10 for this. I'm gonna take my time. I'm gonna find all the other 5 issues. It will be worth it, because David Finch honestly is, in my opinion, the best comic book artist of this modern age. That's the end of that. All right, what else did I find? Oh yeah, finally completed my set of Cosmic Ghost Rider, because as you know, guys, Frank Castle, the Punisher, is now the Cosmic Ghost Rider. It's a crazy-ass story. I love it. I had number 1, 2, 4, and 6. Was missing 3 and 5. I found it pretty cheap, like $4 each. All good, man. Oh, yeah. The Joker. 80th anniversary special. This is the Lee variant cover, the 2000s cover. Pretty cool, pretty cool. A little bit expensive, but hey man, it's 100 pages, it's gonna be worth it. What else? Oh yeah, another series that I used to have, threw away, have to rebuy it. Deathstroke, the Terminator, classic, number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, and then 6, 7, 8 with Batman. I know, guys, I'm missing number 9 to complete the first two story arcs. What the hell are you going to do about it? I will find it someday, because they're not that expensive. Now, on to the big boys. Now, all the comic books that I just showed you, that was the fun part. You know, no real keys, low priced. But these, my friends, these are the big books. As I told you, I am a Punisher and a big Conan fan, and I am currently on a quest to finish the complete run of Savage Sword of Conan. That's right. In one of my previous videos, you saw that I just bought the number 1, which is great. And these are the Savage Swords that I found at the Montreal Comic Con. Savage Sword number 6. Not in the best of shape, still, it is a Savage Sword number 6. Didn't pay much, so that was worth it. Savage Sword number 9. Savage Sword number 13. Quite hard to get. You don't see it much, you don't see it a lot. Number 14, very cool cover. Number 18. Number 21. 28. Classic Earl Norm cover. 30. Number 39. One of the most beautiful Savage Sword of Conan covers of all time by Earl Norm. Number 48. 49. 50. Crazy, crazy finds. Number 54. This one too is harder to get. I don't know why, but you don't see it as often. Number, what is this? 57. Very cool. 58. Beautiful. 59. This is such a beautiful cover by Clyde Caldwell. He used to do these all kinds of Dungeons and Dragons art for TSR back in the day. And it shows beautiful, beautiful cover. Number 62. Whatever. Number 64 by Joe Jusco, my favorite artist. Beautiful. 65, another Joe Jusco. Check it out. Beautiful. What is this? 66. 67. 69. 70. Another beautiful Earl Norm cover. And what else? Number 97. Now, I just found out that the artist who did this is named Gaetano Liberatore. And as you can see, he's got a very, very peculiar form of art style, right? And I was looking at it, and I was thinking to myself, I've seen this kind of artwork before, but where? I just could not remember where I saw this type of artwork. And then it came to me as in a flash. This guy used to do the artwork for an Italian comic book character called
Rangzarox. Very, very underrated, very hardcore, sex and violence. If you know of this character, Rangzarox, hey, let me know what you think, man. It's awesome. I also bought number 98. All in all, I am missing 18 Savage Swords now. All below issue 100. But the biggest one that I did buy at the Montreal Comic Con, and when I found it, my heart stopped, because this book is quite rare. Not super expensive, but quite rare. I've been looking for this book for many, many, many years. That's right. This is the Marvel Comics Super Special number 2 from the early 70s. Savage Sword of Conan special in full color. I do have the number 9, which is basically the same thing. But number 2 has always eluded me. And I was looking through the boxes of the Savage Sword magazines, and it just happened to be there. $20 price tag. It's in very good condition. But yeah, so I was kind of freaking out. And this is what I would consider, for me, a small grail. This is very, very hard to get. A beautiful, beautiful Earl Norm cover. It's actually a gatefold cover. So, yeah, I was very happy about that. And that being said, guys, if you like this video, please like, subscribe, you know what to do. You can comment. I will answer any and all comments. I love you guys. And please tell everybody around you to watch my videos, subscribe. Much, much more coming up. This is the fabulous Four-Fingered Freak saying, see ya, baby.